Good morning, students. Today, I, Mrs. Hajra, will be teaching you the chapter Matter in Our Surrounding. This is the first chapter of the CBSE Class 9 syllabus. The whole chapter I will be teaching you in 4 modules. Today, I am discussing with you the first module, that is the microscopic concept of the matter. Children, what is matter? Any substance which has mass and occupies space is known as matter. Mass means that the amount of the substance present in the body or the object is known as mass. Space is the volume occupied by the matter. For example, if we have a chair made up of wood, the amount of the wood is the mass and the volume occupied by the chair is the space. So, the wooden chair is a matter. Now, the matter we have to discuss the microscopic concept. Matter consists of very, very tiny particles. These tiny particles are invisible to us. We can understand this by understanding two more experiments. One is, we take a glass of water and we add sugar to it. What we find, the sugar completely disappears and the level of the water is not rising. This shows that the particles of the sugar gets fit into the space of the water. That shows that particles of the sugar is so small that it can get fit into the space of the water molecule. A second experiment, children, that particles are so tiny and they can be divided also. For example, we take 5 glasses, transparent glasses, and we mark it from outside at equal level. We fill equal amount of water in all the 5 glasses. In the first glass, we add 1 spoon of ink and we make it a solution. In the second glass, we take again 5 ml of the first solution and we add into the second glass. In the third glass, we add again 5 ml of the solution second and we add it into the third glass. We continue the process for 5 times and we see the color of the ink continuously fades. This is because the particles of the ink are dividing. It is getting scattered out in different solution with small amount, and thus it also proves that particle of the ink is very, very small. It infers that the particles of the matter is very, very small in size. Now, child, we are going to discuss about the nature of these particles, the small particles. The first one, the particles have space between them. This we have just now studied an experiment that if you take a glass of water, if you add sugar or a salt, any dissolving material, the particles gets into the space of the water and it shows that particles of the water has space between them. So all particles of the matter has space between them. It can be larger space, it can be smaller space. Second property of the particles of matter is that particles of the matters are continuously moving. Now, any moving in a particle which is moving and having an energy, that energy is known as kinetic energy. This you will understand when we burn incense stick or we put some strong perfume on our clothes, we can feel it from a distance. Why do we feel it from a distance? Because these particles of the perfume or the particles of the burning incense stick, they get move into the air particles because the air, it is having a kinetic energy. And that shows that particles of the matter are continuously moving and we can feel it from a distance. But the movement of the particles into each other depends on the density. If the density of the liquid or the density of the matter is very, very high, then the process of the mix passing of the particles is takes a larger time. So they are slow down. So the movement of the particles again depends on their density. Similarly, child, if we make the substance hot, the particles will move much more faster. You know that the sugar dissolves faster in hot water. Why? Because the hot water has water particles which are moving much faster and creating lot of space. And the greater the space, more is the sugar particles dissolving into it. The third property is the particles of matter attract each other. Now, we know that when we take an iron piece and a piece of chalk, we compare them now, and we try to break them. Iron is not easily broken, but the chalk piece breaks up very, very fast. This is because the particles of the chalk has a weaker force of attraction compared to the particles of the iron, which has a very strong force of attraction, so it cannot be broken. Similarly, if you put your finger through the running water, you cannot break the water flow of the water. Only thing, the water changes its direction because the particles of the water has a force of attraction which we cannot easily break. But in the next module, we will study that the kinetic energy of the particles and the force of attraction between the particles of the matter decides whether the matter will be solid, liquid, or gas. Now, the mixing up of the particles of the two different forms of matter has a special definition that is known as diffusion. Children, this is all about the first module. This is followed by, we have given you notes that you have to write in your register, and there is followed by an assignment also.